Getting into adventure riding can be tough for shorter riders. Some bikes like the Honda XR650L and KTM 640 Adventure are so tall you need to be at least 6 foot high to ride them comfortably. Much of this is driven by the apparent need for huge amounts of suspension and a comfy seat. In the early days, motorbikes were so low, even a kid could have both feet flat on the ground. First, bike selection. If you are keen on the bigger adventure bikes, here is a rough guide to some of the lower bikes available. Great to see Triumph offering the lowest seat height in a specially lowered model. It's also one of the lightest bikes in this category too. Remember, seat height can vary across year models. For example, in 2019, the Honda CB500X had a bigger front wheel, so it sat higher. And the figure for the Africa Twin is using Honda's lowering link. One potential problem? These larger bikes are still quite heavy, especially for very short and or inexperienced riders. So, lighter adventure bikes with low seat heights. The Royal Enfield has a low seat height, but unfortunately it's crazy heavy and has a very detuned engine. The 300 models from Kawasaki and BMW are both worth looking at. While the DR650 isn't technically an adventure bike, the lowering link does allow a low seat height for a big engine capacity, and you can drop the height a lot more with aftermarket seats. The KTM 390 Adventure is getting a bit on the tall side, but KTM do have a factory lowering kit that will lower the bike by another 25mm or 1 inch. How low can you go? Well, these are dual sport bikes. If you want a really low seat height, look at the Suzuki VanVan and the Yamaha TW200. And yes, quite a few riders take these fat-tired wonders across the country. Many of the small dual sport bikes have quite low seat heights. The Yamaha XT250 and Suzuki DR200 are among the lowest. But what about all those experienced adventure riders who are short and want a quality bike with good performance? This is usually when you start looking at modifying an existing model to suit. Your most basic mod, cut the seat down and recover it yourself, or buy a lower aftermarket seat. The width of the seat is usually a problem too. You can usually taper the seat at the front for when your feet need to be on the ground. If you can dramatically reduce seat height, you may want lower foot pegs too, so your legs don't feel cramped. Suspension mods. If you are short, chances are you are lighter as well, so softer springs front and rear might give you enough suspension sag to be comfortable on the bike. Cheapest and most basic suspension mod is a lowering link for the rear shock, and slide your forks through the triple clamps to suit. It's very easy to change this back to stock as well. Most riders find it works great, but a few may find the rear shock doesn't work quite so well with the changed geometry, and it may change the handling of the bike. You usually need a shorter side stand as well. The other option is to have your shock and forks both altered by a suspension professional to sit the bike lower. Expensive and not easy to reverse, but for some, this is the best solution. Handlebars. Usually the height will be okay, but some short riders trim the bar ends to feel more comfortable on the bike. Get riding boots with thicker soles. I can't find any adventure boots specifically made for short riders, but some do get their boots modified. Riding style. Get used to just putting one foot down when you stop, not both. If you do need to get one butt cheek off the seat to do this, practice putting a foot down on each side of the bike at a standstill until the butt slide becomes second nature. Work on your balance. Nothing perfects this like balancing at a standstill. Check out Ina Coleman on her DR650. A less ambitious way to do this is with full lock turns, both standing and sitting. Learning to ride very slowly will also improve your clutch slipping skills. Get comfortable standing on the foot pegs. In rough terrain, you can move your body around much more to maintain balance. When parking, don't be embarrassed to get off the bike and just walk it into parking spots. Anything that gives you more control and less risk cannot be a bad thing. For more tips, see our Dirt Tips for Short Riders on our Enduro channel. If you have any bike choice recommendations or other tips, let us know and we'll add them to the pinned first comment on YouTube and our Facebook post. Ride safe.